Hello and welcome to the Autosport International BTRDA Clubman's Rallycross Championship. It's round 7, the final round, and we're at a very wet and windy Croft for another exciting day's racing. Let's catch up with the drivers down in the pits.
Mark, last round of the championship, you're in 4th place overall.
Yeah.
How do you think your chances are today?
Confident with it. Car's going well. As long as we don't get no problems. We'll be there with it.
Dimitri, Clubman 4x4, you're leading the championship at the moment. Gary Pusey's level on you with points. It's all going to go down to the wire today.
Well, yeah, not sure what's going to be the end for it, but I just do my best and we'll try to keep the car in one piece. So that's the priority at the moment.
Somewhat of a different venue this weekend than the Gymkhana Grid Finals in Greece last weekend. How do you think you'll cope with the wet and the wind of Croft?
Oh, it's a totally different story. It was nice, bright and shiny there, with lots of grip and care. Look, it's like an old ice rink.
Excellent. Well, best of luck for this afternoon.
Thank you.
Todd, Super Modified Championship for you, currently sitting fourth. It's not been the easiest of years for you.
No, it's not been the best of years. I mean, we started off this year by developing the new turbo on the car, which meant we missed the first two. Well, we didn't miss them, but we ended up running in smaller cars for the first two rounds. Then once we got that bit out of the way, we only had, four rounds left, and then blind we blew the head gasket. So it's not been the best of years for points-wise, but hopefully go out there, have a good fun today and see what happens.
Good to see you back out today anyway, and there's a good chance of a podium position in the championship. Do you reckon you might be able to manage it?
I hope so. We're very quick today. It seems to me we're fifth overall after that first heat, which was nice. And it's very, very slippery out there, so that holds all the rear-wheel drive cars back. So. Yeah, good chance of going well today, and therefore, as it's double points, hopefully doing better in the championship.
Excellent, best of luck.
Thank you.
The Production B final was the first race of the finals, and it was Peter Hamlett who came out in front from the start in his 306 GTI. However, that lead was not to last the entire race. A spin later on would hand that lead over to Fred Ling. Fred Ling would be under pressure from Josh Bowes, but he held his nerve and the lead to move into the A final. So first up of the full races, and it is the Mel Williams Tyres Production A final. The championship could go down to the wire here. James Orton leading the crews off the start line. But it is John Ward behind him. They're both fighting for the overall win of the BTRDA Autosport International Championship. That's Martin Peters coming around the outside. He runs onto the gravel and hits James Orton. James Orton's going to spin and John Ward's going to go through. That could be James Orton's championship hopes dashed for the year. If he can't get going again, that's a big moment there for Colin Rumsey in the Peugeot 205. But it is John Ward who comes down onto the gravel section for the first time in the lead of the race. Martin Peters there with some significant front end damage on his Saxo. But this is quite a turn up for the books. If John Ward now can hold his nerve for the next 4.5 laps, he will take the championship. But James Orton is not going to take that lying down. So round they go for the first lap, and it is John Ward running away in the lead. Something he has done a few times this year, but he's also struggled on some rounds. You can see the slippery conditions there. It's very wet and muddy here at Croft. Martin Peters running wide once again there. That's Joe Muskauskas. He's had a difficult season, but he's starting to get to grips with his cars. But you can see one after another they go onto the gravel. That at the back of the field is James Orton. Not a place that he'll be wanting to be. The points are very close. If he can get a good few positions, he may well clinch this championship. But it remains to be seen. You can see the gap now between them. John Ward already starting to pull away, running wide onto the very slippery surface there. You can see how much time he's losing. These production cars, of course, quite basic, and they struggle in the slippery conditions. So around they go at the hairpin once again. John Muskauskas followed by Colin Rumsey. And that looks like James Orton has gained one position back already, but John Ward is at least a third of a lap ahead of him. as he comes back down into the bottom hairpin. And that is Martin Peters there, dropping back slightly. The number 514 car, Richard Todd, getting past him. Martin Peters with a big sideways moment, just covered it up before he hit the tyre wall. And James Orne is trying to keep it nice and neat and gain those positions back, working his way back up the leaderboard. But John Ward comes back down onto the gravel, bumping away and sliding about on this very, very slippery conditions. Many of the drivers saying it's the worst they've ever seen it, which is understandable given the pretty horrendous weather. But you can see he's a great man at car control, John Ward. He's making it look a little bit easy. So James Orton has now taken the Peugeot 205 Colin Rumsey. He moves up another place. Certainly not going down without a fight. Martin Peters is battling on in his Saxo. Some quite a lot of front end damage from that impact early on in the race, but he's not giving up. All importantly, his wipers are still working to keep trying, keep that screen clear from mud. You can see how much mud these cars are picking up just after a couple of laps. So that's Mark Finch being overtaken there, and that's Fred Ling just going in front of him. Joe Muskauskas has dropped to the back of the pack. He won't be too happy with that, but he's had a good year this year, struggling to make the B finals early on, and is now a consistent A final runner. It remains to be seen what he can do in 2017. We're back at the hairpin. James Orton is now catching the man in front, which is Richard Todd. But it is John Ward who has a healthy lead now. You can see that gap between him and the second car off, Graham Rumsey. So John Ward are looking to try and keep things comfortable and keep that first position. So around they go, back onto the gravel once again. John Ward now looks like he's maybe coming off the throttle a bit, taking it a little bit steady just to make sure he makes it to the finish, which is certainly understandable. It's been a tough year for Mr. Ward. He has had a few difficult results and spins in the finals, but consistency counts, and that's why they've made the points. But here he is, the man of the hour, John Ward. He's going to cross the line to take the win and the championship title of the Autosport International BTRDA Clubman's Rallycross Championship. Let's have a look at the rest of the results. Graham Rumsey comes in second, Martin Peters in third, Richard Todd in fourth, Orton fifth, Ramsey sixth, Ling seventh, Finch eighth, and Muskauskas ninth. Let's get down and have a chat with our race winner.
John, another race win for you this year. You must be really chuffed.
Delighted. Absolutely delighted. Can't believe it. It was a great, great race. Great day overall. Got a medium start, and James leading in the first corner. Martin passed me around the outside, and that happened. But no, it was a great, great day overall.
A bit unlucky for James there, getting making a bit of contact early on in the race.
And it dropped him back. Yeah, it was very unfortunate. I didn't want to win the championship that way, but I did.
A win's a win, though, and you take home the prize this weekend.
I do, yes. Thanks very much.
Excellent. Cheers.
Thanks.
So next up is the combined Scooby Clean Racing and the Kartech Motorsport Production and Clubman four-wheel drive races, both categories bundled into one for their A final. Good to see some supercars here today, regulars in the British Rallycross Championship, and we've got at the moment that is Simon Horton in the Subaru running wide there. That gives Mad Mark Watson, as they call him, the lead early on in this race. He's in the Zara WRC kit car Rallycross vehicle. So as you can see there, the more production-based cars at the back of the field. But the slippery conditions today could certainly hand them an opportunity for an upset. So as they come down the gravel for the first time, it is Mark Watson followed by Simon Horton. See how much more grip these cars have compared to the production cars before. Ryan in the Nissan GTR just going through there as they go round to finish the first lap and start the second. So Mark Watson comes round the bottom corner, followed by Simon Horton. Simon Horton trying to keep it in a straight line. Big slide there. Dimitri Shrevny struggling to gather it up. That lets Liam Manning pass. Liam and Dimitri having a somewhat of a battle all season this year as they come back round. That is contact there just off camera. We just caught the edge of that. Pretty sure that was Liam Manning just making contact with the back of Dimitri Shrevny. And the red flags are out. Yeah, that is Liam Manning off there. That's Gary Busey off. There's cars off all over the place here. This doesn't look particularly good for the race. They do seem to have got going again. And they are... Yes, they are away. So, Mark Watson comes back down to the bottom of the circuit and back to the hairpin on the tarmac. And it is James Lyon in second place. That is a red flag there underneath the camera. We can just see it. The red flags are being waved. The race has been stopped. It looks like that's Dimitri Shrevny in the barrier there with some significant damage. So the race restarted. Missing a couple of regular competitors. It was Mike Manning who made contact with Dimitri Shrevny early on there. My apologies. Both of them will not be restarting. So Mark Watson heads off once again, followed by Simon Horton and James Lyon behind him. James Lyon having a bit of a skid there, struggling to keep the grip. That's Gary Pusey in the Subaru behind them. This could well hand Gary Pusey the championship. Dimitri Shrevny was fighting with Pusey all season for this championship. He's now pulled out of this race, so it is Gary Puce is to lose. As long as he makes the finish of this race, he will become 4x4 champion for 2016. Mark Watson, a BRC, British Rallycross regular, making an appearance here at the BTRDA. Simon Horton as well. He is a British Rallycross regular. It's good to see them coming, competing on the Autosport International BTRDA Championship. So he comes back down once again. Big power of that Zara. On the straights he can pull away, but in the sideways, that is Simon Horton. A big moment there. He's away onto the grass. But it isn't going to affect him. So Pusey goes through into third place for now. Simon Horton is not going to be letting him away so easily. So Mark Watson, big sideways as they come into the hairpin. A nice comfortable lead opening up now. James Lyon and the GTR taking an interesting line into that corner. Maybe not the quickest, but that is Gary Pusey coming in third. He's ran a little bit wide there, trying to outbrake himself. That's Simon Horton. Goes down the inside with Pusey on the grass. Pusey will be kicking himself in there. But it is Mark Watson who is now thundering down the main straight into the square right at the bottom. But it is James Lyon who is not letting him away. He's working hard to try and keep up in his Pulsar GTIR. But will he have the time to do it? That is the question. You can see how hard James Lyon is having to drive to try and keep pace with Mark Watson. Mark Watson looking particularly comfortable now as they come through this slippery, you could say gravel. It's probably more just mud today. It seems to be a nice, smooth, steady line through there. Is the quickest way through. That is Simon Horton coming through in third place. He's claimed that place back and held it. You can see the gap now to Gary Pusey. Pusey with a much more conservative line this time. But it is the battle for the first position. He's going to go down to the last couple of laps. James Lyon has made that space up. And Mark Watson's under pressure here. But can he make it stick? James Lyon pushing hard. Tries to keep it neat through the long right-hander before they go into chicane. And we're looking at Gary Pusey currently in fourth position. And still in position to now win the Club and 4x4 Championship this year. So, it is Mark Watson still under pressure. James Lyon is after him. What can he do down the back straight? Can he keep pace with the Zara? That's Simon Horton in a league of his own in third place at the moment. But it is the front two who are attracting all the attention now as they come down the back straight. James Lyon's not going to be able to make a move. He's not close enough this time. It looks like Mark Watson's trying to keep that driving style nice and neat and tidy. That's a big slide there from James Lyon. He's going to lose time. A bit of a mistake. Could that be the end of the challenge? But there is still time to go yet. However, not much. Only a couple of corners. That is Ian Shelley we just saw going through a shot there. He's going to be lucky not to be lapped. Trying his best to make it round in these tough conditions. But that is Mark Watson. He is cleanly round the final hairpin. James Lyon is in sideways. He's trying to do everything he can to keep up with him. But it looks like it's going to be Mark Watson who comes over the finish line to take the race win. And James Lyon is going to follow him in second. So Simon Horton comes in third place. Carrie Pusey in fourth, taking that championship win. Liam Manning fifth, David in sixth, and Burke in seventh. Ian Shelley rounds it off in eighth.
Mark, 4x4 race win today. You must be really chuffed with that.
Yeah, after all the problems I had at the Grand Prix and not even finishing one heat, that it's gone pretty well today. And the car's back on form, so it's a good stance is in good stead for next season.
Look pretty slippery out there.
I've never known it as going to Croft for 30 years and I've never known it as slippery as that. Whatever tyres I put on, I couldn't get any grip. Hence why there's cars that are half the power of me right up the back end of me. But it was just a case of keeping it in a straight line. And when you got the tarmac, put the power down there.
Excellent, congratulations, enjoy your beer.
Thank you very much, yes, well earned.
So next up we had the Junior Rallycross A final and we're just going to have a quick look at some of the highlights of this race. Tom Constantine got off the grid first to take the lead of the race, closely followed by Morgan Root. Morgan Root getting a lot quicker during the these guys, British Rallycross Junior regulars as well. Root would try and make a move on Constantine but wouldn't quite get close enough during the early stages of the race. And that may have cost him because later on he came under pressure from Jayden Bennett. Moving into second, he was nudged out the way but with a little bit of assistance there into third position. But the battle wasn't yet over. These slippy conditions making for difficult racing conditions. And it was Morgan Root who kept the pressure on Jayden Bennett and eventually made his way past back into second place. But it was Tom Constantine who took the race win. Morgan Root coming in second, Jayden Bennett in third, and Laura Boak in fourth.
Tom, slippy conditions today, but a junior rallycross win for yourself.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy. It's been a bit treacherous out there. I've had some good races, not being able to see who's behind us because all the back windscreen's obviously being covered in mud, but a good day really, I'm fairly happy.
This is the first event you've been in the BTRDA Championship this year.
Yeah, it is, yeah. I did the test day at Blighton at the start of the season and we've never really had time or just never been able to get to them, any of the other meetings, but we saw there was quite a good entry building up for this, we decided to put an entry in and yeah, it's been a good day.
Any plans for 2017?
Well, we're in the British Championship again next year, but we were just saying then we're thinking about maybe doing a couple of these rounds. If there's going to be some good competition, obviously we'll probably end up doing this event next year, maybe some at Blighton, because none of them are that far for us, really.
So another season in the juniors or a step up to something a little bit more powerful?
No, another season in the juniors. I'm not old enough next year. I could technically do this season after, but I think my brother will end up getting the junior car and I'll either move on or have to watch from the sidelines for a year or so.
Excellent. Well, congratulations and we'll catch you next time.
Thank you.
Next up then, the historic B final. Steve Gaunt Trailers sponsored category, and it was always exciting racing in these classes, lots of new faces, and Neil Maynard in the Triumph TR8 led the race from early on. Number 17, David Ewan, having a spin on the very first corner, but it was Neil Maynard who went to dominate the race from start to finish. Nigel Murray in the Nova would try his best to put some pressure on Maynard, but it wasn't to be. Number 9 car holding his nerve and taking that race win. Nigel Murray would follow him through into the A final. So into the historic A final for the last time in 2016, and from the line, Gary Simpson in the BMW E30 takes the lead. That's John Buckley just behind him. A bit of rubbing there between Ryan Stutchbury and Darren Grimston. Darren Grimston leaving the road there and heading off onto the grass. He's lost a bag of places there. Oh, just about getting out the way of Gary Mitchell, having to take avoiding action there. Mitchell been struggling today in these conditions. The Vectra proving to be a little bit of a handful, but from what we hear, there is a new car in production for 2017. But back to this race, and at the front, it is Gary Simpson. The front is the place to be, the place with the clean windscreen. All important in these conditions. So they go around the muddy and messy hairpin. For the first time, Neil Maynard struggling a little bit in the TR8 in this race after that race win in the B's. And it is going to be Gary Simpson who comes over in the lead on lap one. Sean Buckley is going to be trying his best to keep up with him. He's struggling a little bit in the Escort, away onto the gravel there, followed closely by that British Leyland Mini of Lance Foster. Sean Buckley pulls out of the way, Lance Foster goes down the inside. Buckley looks to have a problem here. Ryan Stutchbury passes him, Vince Bristow goes past. Certainly looks like he's succumbed to some technical fault. So Gary Simpson holds the lead, but it is Lance Foster in the Mini who is now in second place. Third place is Ryan Stutchbury in the 205, reveling in these muddy conditions, able to use his power more efficiently. There's not as much power in that 205 as some of the quicker cars, and in conditions like this he can certainly keep pace with the best. So they go around, that's Gary Mitchell going through there, that's Sean Buckley now is at the back of the field. Will he keep going? His battle is for this historic championship title. So can he keep going? If he finishes the race, there's a good chance he'll take the points and the championship with it. But there is a long way to go, but it is Gary Simpson pulling out a lead now, followed by the Mini of Lance Foster, Ryan Stutchbury, then Vince Bristow is currently sitting in fourth place. As they come back down on the mud, slip sliding away, and certainly difficult with the rear wheel drive car in these conditions. And it is anyone's game so far. Vince Bristow looking for a way past Stutchbury. He's had a few good races this year, certainly at the Pembrey Rounds. However, has also struggled in some others. But Gary Mitchell is looking to be a little off the pace today. Being chased there by the Mini of Neil Maynard. Gary Simpson a little bit sideways there, trying to keep it all in one piece. Well, that is Vince Bristow there. That is the fourth place. Vince Bristow pulling off the track. He must have a technical problem. So, Nigel Grimston in the Nova GSI moves up into fourth place. He's going to be now trying to catch Stutchbury. Quite a big gap between the front of them, though. And then it is Nigel Murray, followed by the Mini of Ian Clark. And then Gary Mitchell in the Vectra. But back to the front of the pack, and it is Gary Simpson going round, followed by Lance Foster. And Ryan Stutchbury looking to be able to make inroads on these guys. Struggling down the straights a little bit, but he may well be able to catch them before the end. So they head over the start-finish straight once again for the final time in this race. And it is Gary Simpson holding this lead as they come down to hairpin. The number 52 car, keeping it all in a straight line, keeping it all gathered up. And there is not long left to run in this race. We do appear possibly to be missing Gary Mitchell there, we didn't see him, but as Gary Simpson comes over for the final time, he goes round the hairpin, keeping it neat and tidy now, and he is going to go over the line. There is Gary Mitchell, he is still going, he's been chased by Sean Buckley. The championship is between these two, so Buckley will be desperately trying to find a way past him in what's left of this race. But it is Gary Simpson who goes over to take the win. Lance Foster comes in second, followed closely by Ryan Stutchbury. Darren Grimston's coming in fourth. Murray in fifth. Buckley sixth. He gets past Mitchell and Maynard in eighth.
Gary Simpson, winner of the historic class today. Looked a tough and slippy race. How did you find it?
Certainly tough and slippy all day. Some of the worst conditions I've been in up here, like it's been real slippery. Not really rear-wheel drive weather today, I don't think, but it was a case of survival, I think, you know what I mean? If you stay on the circuit, you're in a chance of winning, and that's what we tried to do, and we seemed to go quite well.
Certainly ran well from start to finish there. The battle seemed to be going on behind you. Did you enjoy having the track all to yourself?
Yes, that was the aim, in the heats and in the finals, to be at the first corner first and hopefully let everybody else fight for it. Keep a clear screen, because that's half the battle, you know. You can see, if you can see where you're going, you're in with a chance of getting there. But what was going on behind, no idea. Couldn't see a thing.
Excellent. Congratulations on your win today.
Smashing. Thank you very much.
So next up, the Fuchs Lubricant Super Modified B final, and it was Tyce Heason in the Volvo C30 who led from the start, but the race was soon stopped. Chris Furu in the Suzuki Swift having a little altercation with the tyres early on. Once the race got restarted though, it was the Irishman Kieran Curran and championship regular who took the lead. There was tyres coming everywhere once again, but the race was continued. The circuit not blocked this time. And it ran in its entirety to the finish. Always exciting racing in these super modified cars. Tyce Heason would put pressure on Curran, with Kenny Hall, championship regular, also tagging along the top three. But it was Curran and Heason who went through to the A final. So the final race of the weekend and the Fuchs Lubricant Super Modified A final. They line up on the start line and they are away from the start, down the main straight into the first corner. And it is looking like it is the Ford KA Sport of Tony Lynch who is going to come in to the first corner leading the race. That is Mark Jones in second. Todd Crooks looking a little bit out of shape there. He struggled this year with some difficult results, but has got going. You can see the light is fading there. Late in the day here at Croft, and the weather conditions are not getting any better. The rain has lifted slightly, but the track is still very, very wet and slippery. But it is Tony Lynch coming into the first gravel section and the first hairpin of this race. In the lead, Mark Jones follows him, and it is Michael Boak in third place. That's the Vauxhall Tigra of Alex Fawcett, running a little wide on that corner. So as they come back down the main straight, it is Tony Lynch. He's going to be overtaken by Michael Boak. Boak going around the outside, but it is Lynch who manages to somehow hold on to that first place position. So they come back down into the tarmac section, and it is Lynch holding on to the lead. Boak's in second. Jones in the MR2 is in third. He's had an up and down season this year. He'll be looking for a solid result here. And Todd Crooks has managed to move into fourth place. Big slide there at the back. But we go back to the front of the field, and they come down. Boak is all over the back of Lynch. He's putting a lot of pressure on him here. Can Lynch hold his nerve into the hairpin? And he does, nice and clean and tidy around there. And back they go down the main straight as the rest of the field make their way through on the hairpin. That is the big Volvo C30 of Tyce Heason taking another interesting line thrown there. That is Michael Boak. He has taken Tony Lynch, but can he hold on to that as they come back onto the tarmac? Tony Lynch goes down the inside. There's contact. Boak sideways onto the gravel. He holds it. Big splash through the water. But somehow Michael Boak has held on to that race lead, and an excellent bit of driving, maybe a little bit of luck involved there. That's Mark Jones spinning out there. He'll be He'll be quite annoyed with himself there, trying to avoid the rest of the field. Crikey almighty. So he gets going again. And well, what a couple of corners of racing. All changed in the top three. So Michael Boak comes back round, leading the race now in the Citroën C2, followed by the Ford KA Sport of Tony Lynch. And who is going to be in third place? That is Todd Crooks now into third. That is a solid performance from him. Try and avoid all of this trouble that's going on in the race. And that is a car just pulling over there. Looks like a Suzuki Swift. Just pulling out there with a mechanical fault. So Michael Boak comes back down around the bottom of the tarmac section, keeping it neat and tidy. And it looks like he is pulling away quite a lead already. Quite a bit more power than Tony Lynch in the KA. Kieran Curran there, our B final winner. He's making his way through, currently in fourth place, followed by the Mini Cooper of David Bell. He's under pressure there from the Tigra of Alex Fawcett, looking for a way past. Big wiggle there, nearly got himself out of shape. But it is Boak who is leading this race, taking out the barrier there. That could upset the rest of the crews, making their line a little bit more difficult, pushing them onto the slippier surface. But it is Tony Lynch round, and it is Todd Crooks following him. The Mini, plenty of power in that Mini this year, doing a lot of development work on it, but Kieran Curran is looking for his way past. But Michael Boak is still leading. The number 81 car running away with this race now. A huge gap between him and Tony Lynch. And it is Todd Crooks somewhat having the track all to himself in third place now, as he makes his way around the bottom of the circuit. Excellent place for spectators this. But the Tigra of Alex Fawcett is still looking for a way past David Bell in his Mini. But back to the front, Boak comes round. Nice and steady now on the final corner of this race. And it is going to be Tony Lynch who follows him in the Ford KA. So over the line goes Michael Boak to take the race win. Tony Lynch is going to come in second. Crooks is going to be going through in third place, but the battle's still going on. That looks like Alex Fawcett's made his way past David Bell. So Kieran Curran comes in fourth. Alex Fawcett in fifth. Bell six. Jones in seventh. And Tyce Heason in eighth.
Fuchs Lubricants Super Modified A Final. Michael Boak, you're the winner today. You must be pleased with that.
Very pleased, yeah. Yeah, we've had a very tough year. We've had loads of problems with the car. So to finally get some reliability and show the pace that we've had today, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Certainly slippy conditions there, but you dominated the race from start to finish.
Absolutely horrendous conditions. You spend half the time when you're on the track like that. The screen's full of mud, you just cannot see where you're going. A lot of it's just driven by instinct. So, yeah, no, it was good to come away with a win at the end of the day.
Excellent, congratulations.
Thank you very much, cheers.
So that's it. That is the end of 2016 in the Autosport International BTRDA Clubman's Rallycross Championship. The overall win going to John Ward, just by 2.5 points over James Orton. In the Super Modified, Mark Jones made that finish stick and takes the win in that category. Production, John Ward and James Orton. Richard Todd in third. Historic Sean Buckley holds on to finish the race and take that category win, with a 5-point lead over Ryan Stutchbury. Production 4x4 went to Mike Manning. His son Liam Manning coming in second. Clubman 4x4 went to Gary Pusey with that retirement of Dimitri Shrebny. And the Julian Rallycross, Jayden Bennett takes the championship win by 0.5 point over Morgan Root. Laura Boak makes it off in third. It's been an excellent and exciting season this year, I think you'll all agree, and we look forward to the 2017 championship. Look at this final lap coming past. Tommy Graham goes through. He's got a problem here. He's just going to cross the line ahead of Patrick Graham. Martin Peters goes out wide. He tries to come back on the inside and he's made contact. That is James Orton, who is now off the track and pushed two back on the field. Could that be his championship hopes dashed? The man of the hour, John Ward, the championship winner of the 2016 Autosport International BTRDA Clubman's Rallycross Championship.